Hello and welcome everyone. Today I am going to take a new lesson on Core 3, ASP.NET Core 3 Web API, which is learning controller action return types. So here is my learning outcome. This tutorial discusses the ASP.NET Core 3 Web API controller action return types. So we'll take how the synchronous action, asynchronous action in code for the IAction result type. So in this lecture, I will take just the simple and the synchronous action, and in a later lecture, I will take the asynchronous action, which needs a bit of a more work, okay? But I will please follow my further tutorial on Visual Studio 2019 preview to actually do some hands-on coding. This will be just a theoretical lecture, all right? So let's see how it goes. So specific type, the simplest action returns a primitive or complex data type, for example, string or custom object type. Consider the following action, which returns a collection of custom product objects. Now, you are very familiar with this line of code, which it takes a HTTP GET verb, GET for getting from the database, and it actually, this is a GET method, which returns an IEnumerable of product type. Enumerable, as you are aware, that is a list. It returns from a repository a get products, you know, underscore repository dot get products, you know, it gets a products, all the products in the repository. Now, without knowing conditions to safeguard against during action execution, returning a specific type could suffice. This type could suffice in many of the cases. But when known conditions need to be accounted for in action, multiple return paths are introduced. So we'll see that soon. In such a case, it's common to mix an action result return type. Mark this word action result return type with the primitive or complex return type. So there'll be a mix of this primitive return type with the complex return type, which returns an action result return type. So either IAction result or action result T are necessary to accommodate this type of action. IAction result type we will take first. So the IAction result return type is appropriate when multiple action result return types are possible in an action. The action result types represent various HTTP status codes. Okay. So IAction result return type is appropriate when multiple action result return types are possible in an action. And the action result types represent various HTTP status code, like status code 201, created, new item created. Status code 200 is okay. Status code 404, page not found. Okay. So similarly, some common result type falling into this category are bad request result. If the request is bad, it doesn't fetch anything and it fetches a status code 400, and it is a not found result 404, and okay object result is 200. Okay. Because there are multiple return types and paths in the action, liberal use of produces response type. This is a attribute. This is necessary. Now this attribute produces more descriptive response details for API help pages. Okay. So produces response type indicates the known types and known types and HTTP status codes to be returned by the action. So that's all for today. So in this lesson, we have learned that how the Web API controller action return types work and how the synchronous and the simple result type work in code for IAction result type.